Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Boyan Huang. Today, I would like to present efficient sharing of linked DMA channels on multi-sensor devices by LDMA test scheduler. And this is the outline. First, I'll be talking about the motivation and introduction. Modern medical devices proportion will be smaller, more wearable, lower power consumption, and cost less. The processors today are responsible for performing more input-output tasks because of handling more data from a wider variety of sensors such as ECG, pulse oximeters, and stethoscopes. To support such bulk input-output, the direct memory access mechanisms have been proposed. A DMA controller is set up by the processor to perform bulk transfer directly between input-output and the designated region in memory, and is saved interrupts because processor does not need to get an interrupt on every sample, just one interrupt for every bulk transfer unit. So the processor can remain in sleep mode for longer, or can execute other tasks, because DMA shares the same memory with processor. It will require extra waiting time. Fortunately, modern processors make use of caches, so the extra waiting time makes a minimal impact on the processor performance. To reduce disruptions to the processor, the linked direct memory access has been proposed. Compared to DMA, LDMA supports the linking and synchronization mechanism that can execute a series of DMA transfers without processor intervention. The LDMA controller offers a number of channels. Each channel can be viewed as a hardware thread that can perform executing a linked list of descriptors without processor intervention. So, it effectively reduces the energy consumption for data transfer. Next is related work. To reduce disruptions to the processor between DMA transfers, a number of enhancements to DMA have been proposed. Chen et al. Proposes an application of enhanced DMA to increase the DSP data transfer speed. Wu investigates the use of LDMA for bulk input-output by fixed channel allocation. Wesley and Pezzidoni uses double buffering to minimize delays. However, these works are all dedicated channel allocation. The difficulties that we faced are, first, there are a limited number of LDMA channels due to the hardware design. Second, LDMA use dedicated allocation to assign input-output task. That means the channels are tied to the assigned input-output task, even during idle time. Even though it's intuitive, it's less scalable, because each channel has no sharing opportunity. If we can efficiently use the LDMA channels during idle time, that means the processor can offload more tasks onto LDMA. So, the processor can remain in sleep mode longer, or can execute other tasks. And then the power consumption can be further reduced. And this is our proposed method. An input-output task is the software task that runs on the processor. It can offload its input-output onto one or more LDMA tasks. An LDMA task consists of the linked descriptors to be run on an LDMA channel and its current state of execution. We proposed the LTS to handle the set of LDMA channels to be used for different LDMA tasks. It defines the task priority by its minimum inter-arrival time. In this picture, the LTS dispatched the non-offloaded part to processor. After finishing the input-output task, the LTS config the offloading part to the LDMA channel after context switch in. The LDMA task send an interrupt to LTS upon termination. When the second time the LED signal control task come in, because it has higher priority than flash writing, it will send a stop request to the LTS and do context switch out. After finishing the LED signal control task, the flash writing task switch in and continue. LDMA task scheduler maintains channel states, which is busy if there's a task in the channel, or idle if there's no task in the channel. It also maintains the LDMA task states. This picture shows how LTS maintains the task states. When the task enter, the LTS put the task into the ready queue and change its state blocked to ready. If there's no other LDMA task executing in the same channel partition, then this LDMA task starts immediately and its state is changed to running. The context switch occurs if the coming task has higher priority than the running task. Upon termination, it changes the task state to blocked and starts the next task. Now, I'll be introducing our evaluation device. To motivate our investigation, we consider the blue box system, a data logger for code blue events. Code blue is a common hospital code that indicates a medical emergency, such as cardiac or respiratory arrest. The blue box system is used to log physiological and environmental data and generate a code sheet and a report. We use the blue box system to present an evaluation of our LTS. We first describe the workload of blue box and analyze the task before and after offloading to LDMA controller. The six tasks in blue box system to be scheduled are low rate, IMU sampling, data gathering, flash writing, LED signal control, and AFE sampling. The low-rate task encompasses all services with long periods, including temperature sampling, battery power measurement, USB connection detection, and LED blinking. The IMU sampling task transfers the acceleration and angular velocity data from the FIFO buffer of the IMU every 20 milliseconds over the I2C bus. These two tasks are difficult to convert to LDMA tasks, so we discard these two tasks. And the other four tasks will be offloaded onto LDMA in our experiment. Offloading can be done in the form of either a loop type or non-loop type LDMA task. A loop type LDMA task is for dedicated channel allocation. The LDMA channel repeats executing the descriptors. So the loop type task excludes other tasks from using the channels that it occupies. The non-loop type LDMA returns control to software before starting the next LDMA task execution. In our LTS, a shared channel can run only non-loop type LDMA tasks, which are scheduled within their channel partition. A LDMA channel partition, which means the union of the channels allocated to those input-output tasks if any of their channels overlap. For example, tasks 1, 2, and 4 all have the same allocated channel, which is channel 7. So task 1, 2, and 4 are in the same channel partition, and task 3 is in another partition. After discussing the loop type and non-loop type LDMA task, the question now is, which task should be allocated, dedicated, and which should be shared LDMA channels? The AFE sampling device is the ADS-1298R by Texas Instruments, which contains the analog front end and a simultaneous 24-bit differential pair analog-to-digital converters. The AFE sampling task is the most demanding, as it is invoked 8,000 times a second and is a prime candidate for offloading onto LDMA. Because of the high sampling rate, we offload it by the dedicated allocation to reduce the context switch overhead. And it's our evaluation and comparison. We first define channel utilization for channel partition I as follows. I is the partition number. Ni is the number of tasks in the channel partition I. Tau j is the jth LDMA task in channel partition I. C tau j is the worst case execution time of LDMA task tau j. T tau j is the minimum inter-arrival time of LDMA task tau j. O tau j is the context switch overhead of task tau j. The schedulability of a set of tasks by rate monotonic scheduling can be determined based on the processor utilization. Through the calculation, the utilization of the LTS is close to the schedulable upper bound utilization, so we consider it schedulable before offloading to the LDMA controller. The formula of occupancy is a measure of sharing opportunity. A LDMA channel has 100% occupancy if it's dedicated to one input-output task, because other tasks couldn't use this channel when it's busy or idle. Otherwise, the channel occupancy is the same as utilization if two or more LDMA tasks share the same channel. We first use dedicated channel allocation to schedule the tasks. Without our LTS, the default is to dedicate the LDMA channels to specific tasks. The idea is that by offloading as much as possible to the LDMA this way, we have the chance to reduce the processor load. The table below shows the result of dedicated channel allocation. We found that dedicated channel allocation results in 100% LDMA channel occupancy on all the 8 channels, and the CPU utilization is 19.1%. And then we use LTS to schedule 3 non-loop type tasks in a channel partition. The processor utilization is 19.2%. And it's 0.1 higher than the dedicated channel because context switching incurs overhead. In this table shows the result of using LTS. The LDMA channel occupancies are two channels, channel 4 and channel 5, at 100%. Three channels, channel 1, channel 6, and 7, at 21.2%. And three channels, channel 0, channel 2, and channel 3, at 0%. The LTS reduces the total 8 channel occupancy from 800% down to 263.6% total. This shows that the LTS can efficiently reduce the LDMA channel occupancy, and it enables the system to afford more LDMA tasks, making the MCU scalable to more input-output tasks. In conclusion, Dedicated channel allocation is not always the most efficient solution. It's intuitive, but less scalable. Despite the fact that the multiplex allocation will cause slight overhead, it's scalable to more input-output devices. The LTS we propose to schedule the LDMA task is software structure for multiplexing LDMA channels. It can context switches LDMA channels like hardware threads, and is based on rate monotonic scheduling. This mechanism is applicable to new generation of wearable medical devices, which is high sampling rate, multiple sensing modalities, low power, lightweight, and programmable. Thank you for listening. Thank you for listening.
Questions?
Hello, thank you. This is just a small question. What is the limiting factor for this sort of shared channel scheduling? What if I have a new medical device? How should I design it to be able to do this efficiently?
Actually, the problem is that LDMA channels are limited. Like our device, we just have 8 LDMA channels, and maybe it's up to your design that you may just have 4 or 5 LDMA channels. And if some tasks need the dedicated channel, then the shared channel may be less, and you can use the less space to do this. So it's a limit factor of our proposed mechanism. And I think that the LTS task is hard to offload it because of the channel dedication needs to be defined. Like, because our task is we just propose a mechanism, and the actual way to allocate the LDMA task, we are just thinking about a good way to do this. So it may be some difficult factors, yeah.
Could it be a graph, a matching problem or graph partitioning problem that you could solve via an optimizer, the allocation of devices to shared channels? Is this something that you could solve?
Solve
the allocation, yeah.
I think that we have a part in the paper shows that the AFE sampling task we offloaded can be offloaded to dedicated and multi-channel. It can be loop type or non-loop type. And we choose the loop type because the AFE sampling cost is sampling time is 8,000 times a second. So we think that dedicated channel will be a good way. And it needs 2 channels to do this. So if some task needs more channels to dedicate, then the share space will be less. The space you can use the share channel allocation will be more difficult.
Right now you're this manually, right? You make those decisions manually at this point.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Any more questions? Okay, so thank you very much, and let's